But when did you first find out that you had some extraordinary powers?
About six. I was about 6 years away at that time when I found out this first, you know. And I started water boiling then at that time, you know, and one thing led to another. And then people, by accident more or less, I happened on them and they had a pain in their back, as I put my hand on, and the next day they were okay, you know. So I started from there, and I kept it as quiet as ever I could, for as long as I could.
But of course, naturally, one person speaks to another, and it gets around. Yeah.
I kept going, then from one to the other, and so...
Well, have you had any failures?
Yes. Not so many, but I don't know whether it was a failure through me or through the person themselves, you know.
Well, in what way could they fail?
Well, I don't know. You see, it's not a fate now. It's a gift. A healer I am.
Yes.
You see, it's a gift from God. I think myself anyway, you know, it's a gift from God.
Sometimes, you know, over the past few years, you get the impression that healing of this kind is over-commercialised and exploited in many ways.
Yeah, that's right. Well, that's why I wouldn't like to go too far in that field at all, in case that I'd lose this gift that I got from God, you know. I wouldn't like to make thousands out of it. If I wanted to make thousands, I'd have made thousands years ago, you know.
Well, does it take anything out of you?
Yeah.
I mean, do you feel...
Oh, yes.
...drained or...
Oh, yeah. Completely. I mean, nights should be completely drained out the next morning, you know, after going to bed.
So there's no... I mean, when you were able to relieve other people's pains and afflictions, there's nobody to relieve yours?
No. Only the medical profession. So the doctor, they called in if I'm too bad.
But were other people cured with just a touch of my hand?
Yeah, just touch my hand.
Yeah. In addition,
well, that is not as simple as that. Now, for arthritis, I'd have to do the whole body, like, you know.
Yeah.
But you wouldn't want to strip now. But for skin disease, yes, anything, I'd have to put my hands on the
afflicted spot.
Yeah. Any ringworm you mentioned, you know all the different diseases. But I'd have to go over all them, you know. I'd have to go around them like that, you know.
And now with pains, arthritis, which would be all over the body,
I'd have to start here.
Yeah.
Go down. Start in here and go down. And get out in the fingers and out in the toes.
Well, what do you mean get it out? Do you mean actually force it out?
It'd go out after maybe a day, 2 days, 3 days, 5 days, whatever it be, you know. Different people take different... No, maybe it'd happen there before they leave at all. And maybe it'll be a week before it happened another person, you know.
These gifts must certainly, as I suggested to you, put a fair degree of responsibility on you and strain. But how would you feel if it deserted you altogether? Would you be disappointed?
Well, no. I wouldn't. Because if God wanted to take it, okay, he gave it to me. A priest told me that. I said, why are you driving me around? I said, if anything wrong with me, I go to you. He says, I could do it all, he says, but we don't like doing it. We weren't born for that, he said. You are born for that, he said. And go and do it, he said. You'll never be any worse.
I'm a retired ambulance driver, Frank. I was 32 years with the council.
Wexford
County Council. About 10 years ambulance driving. I built a little bungalow of my own. No help from anybody. I got it 1 grand from the council, all right, definitely. But I had to build it myself. Mullet night and day. Rode a bicycle about 30 miles to work. No such thing as St. Stephen's Day off or anything like that. We had to work every day. So I retired then when I was 65, and I wouldn't retire only for I had a bad leg. And I went out then and applied for a pension, they say. Got the pension, all right. I paid for my pension. No compliment to anybody. And I went on the stamps then and drawn the stamps. and drawing the stamps, £10.40. And the wife come 65, played for the pension poor in February. So about 6 months after, nearly 6 months, she went in Quaffer. No account of the pension couldn't be got. So we looked it up and all like that. 3 days after, she got word that our pension was under consideration. Certain period after that again, she got word about the pension she was getting. They were looking into it. So she got it. She got £1.15 a week. So if that's a pension, call me, Davy.
Well, had your wife any other source of income by any chance?
She surely hadn't. We're both under the care of the doctor. She's under the care of the doctor as well as what I am. Mm-hmm. But then we were thrifting. We never spent a halfpenny. We even hadn't a bicycle until I went retired. Mm-hmm. And then I got a car. And, of course, they took that into consideration. I had a couple of pounds in the bank. But then they came down from Dublin and there was a carpet on the floor and maybe they looked at the carpet. I don't know. What would you think?
Well, did they give you any explanation at all?
Oh, they said my house was too good. And they took that into consideration. I built the house myself and they didn't build it for me. So that's where I am today. But we live it out. What would you say about them?